Hey guys, what's up? How y'all doing? I'm here to talk to you guys about One Piece's new chapter, which is on chapter 1047. Now, this chapter right here was actually very tense here and there. Oda's kind of bringing in the end game right now, which I don't know what's going to bound to happen, but guess we're about to find out, you know? So, if anything else, let's just get this started, you know? We have to it that Yamato tells Momonosuke, you gotta move the island somehow. And we have to it Momonosuke believing that he can't really do it at all, but remembers his time with his mother, his last moments with her before, like, he has to teleport away into the future, you know? And we have to it that, like, Kinemon tries to convince Momonosuke, like, you gotta fight, man. I know this is really shameful right now, but I'd rather fight than burn to death right now. Please, do not mess this up. I will hold my sword for you anyway in any moment. Just please, you gotta fight, you know? And we have to it, Momonosuke reluctantly leaves his mother and says, I'm gonna be going, Mom. Bye. And we have to it that she says her goodbye, and we have to it that Momonosuke says, I either do this or find a way to, or I'll never be able to face my mother, you know? And we have to it, Momonosuke is trying to stop the island right now, while we see Luffy throwing a thunderbolt at freaking Kaido, which is really kind of hilarious and funny, you know? And we have to it, Kaido ends up having to hit Luffy very hard and so forth, and Luffy ends up grabbing another thunderbolt and tries to hit Kaido with it again, you know? But we have to it, Kaido actually makes confirmation about Roger, you know? He actually had no devil fruit power, which is very, very, very hectic and crazy. We all know Goldie Roger was powerful, man. But sometimes we always been trying to wonder, did he ever have any devil fruit power? Which Kaido confirmed that Roger, the former king of the pirates before his execution, had no devil fruit power. He literally freaking brought the world to its heel by using his own haki alone. Which I go, oh my gosh, haki over devil fruit power all the way, you know? Which I thought it was really nice and slick, you know? And we have to it as the episode chapter continues on. Kaido will later on attack Luffy with the powerful Thunder Bagua technique, which is called Death Destroyer or something, you know? And we have to it that Luffy looks like, to me, he's getting a nasty hit on Kaido. He's getting nasty hits from Kaido right now, which I go, well, I don't blame him, you know, that kind of thing. But we have to it, Luffy ends up grabbing onto Kaido and not letting go at all, you know? We have to it that that Kaido gets annoyed by this and tries to hit Luffy's arm, but he would not let go. And we have to it, Kaido goes into his dragon form and ends up attacking Luffy with a freaking, attack of Dragon Twister, you know? And ends up cutting Luffy up, but he still won't let go. And we have to it that we go back to the Flower Capital, which apparently is, sending lanterns into the sky, you know? Which I thought it was really beautiful. Very, very beautiful. And we have to it that freaking, Kaido ends up attacking Luffy with Bolo Breath, and it smoked him up. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this is pretty crazy. And we go back to the dome interior right now, and Hyogoro ends up talking to his subordinates and allies, saying, hey, guys, which one would you prefer? Straw Hat defeating Kaido, or we all die plummeting to our deaths or something, blah, blah, blah. And they go, like, you know what? I'd rather, fight to the very end, you know, that kind of thing. And we have to it, everyone makes a cheer to Luffy saying, hey, take down Kaido once and for all like you always do, you know, etc. And we have to it that that everyone gets attacked by a big, big ocean water thanks to Jinbe and Raizo's teamwork, you know, which I thought it was really cool. Sadly, as for Orochi, you know, apparently the Sea Stone Nail ends up becoming loose out of his, out of his body, and later on, we get to see Orochi going into his devil fruit form, ready to kill Odin's daughter once and for all, or Hiyori once and for all, you know, etc. And we have to it that freaking Luffy gets ready his attack, while Momonosuke and Yamato can only scream in total shock and scared way right now, because Luffy is literally grabbing onto Kaido and planning to finish off Kaido with the giant freaking fist of Gum Gum Thunder Conqueror's Haki, and then we have to it, freaking Yamato's like, are you out of your mind? And Momonosuke say, wait, do you have any idea what you're going to do right now? And we have to it, Luffy's like, hey, Momo, I know you got this, so I'm counting on you, you know? And Momo's like, what? Are you insane? And then Kaido gets ready to take on Luffy's craziest, strongest attack ever, you know? And the chapter ends off there. So, yeah. Oh, man. This is just freaking hilarious. I mean, the moment I saw that attack at the end of the chapter, you know, I was freaking laughing my butt off. I'm like, yeah, this guy's gone mad monkey mode, or mad dog, mad monkey mode, you know? Because he's literally using a giant fist ready to beat Kaido, but at the same time, he may end up destroying Onigashima, you know? Etc. And that's when Momo's like, dude, you have any idea what you're doing? And then, etc. Anyways, you know, it's been confirmed, you know, even though it was maybe a little obvious from the get-go, we don't know. Roger had no devil fruit power. He literally conquered the world or conquered the seas with just his haki and strength alone, which I go like, wow, man, that's what I like about Roger. I mean, like, we all knew he was very powerful. He was one of the most powerful characters in One Piece. We all know that. But, you know, even the most powerful could succumb to a nasty, like, health biological disease that you can't really fight against, you know? I don't know. But one thing's for certain is that things are about to get very crazy now. But depending how Oda ends this, it can either be satisfying or unsatisfying. When I look at Kaido, man, this guy's a beast, man. Even though when Luffy's in this Gear 5, he is still taking hits and not going down without a fight that easily. Or should I say, he doesn't look like he's really being knocked out right now, dude. I mean, as much as I love, like, Luffy, I mean, this just to show, like, how strong a Yonko is. To be honest with you, Law and Kid only got lucky with Big Mom because Law managed to, like, silence Big Mom's voice and tactics and everything without having her homies to come in to help her, you know? As for Kaido, he's just a beast. He's not called the King of Beasts for no reason, you know? Although, like, yeah. Anyways, I'm looking forward to, like, the next chapter. Oda, don't push yourself too hard, man. If you have to take a couple breaks, take a couple breaks, all right? So, yeah, looking forward to next chapter. So, until then, I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm Alpha Zero. Have a good day, and I'll see you guys next time, all right? Peace out. Bye-bye. Toot-toot-toot.